'Cause every time we need you, we're met by love. We can lift our hands to heaven, full of faith. 'Cause every time we worship, we see your face. We see your face. We see your face. We see your face. We see. Thank you. Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens. Who is like you? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens. Who is like you? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens, the first and the last. Who is like you? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens, the first and the last. Who is like you? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens, the first and the last. Who is like you, God? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens. Everything was made through you. Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens. You extend a hand of mercy, Lord. Who is like you? Lord of hosts, you reign in the heavens. Thank you. extend your mercy to the most undeserved. Thank you, Lord. I sing out on my soul that I
you, Lord, that you've redeemed us from the curse of the law. We thank you, Lord, for this last day of the Feast of Purim, where they cast lots for the Jews. And actually, it's the beginning of Holy Week, which culminates in the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for what you're doing in our nation and in ourselves, God. This book of Esther is like a foreshadowing of what's happening even now. So I'm going to read from Esther 3, 8, and 9. Then Haman said to King Azarias, Ahasuerus, there is a certain people scattered and dispersed among the peoples in all the provinces of your kingdom. Their laws are different from those of all other people, and they do not observe the king's laws. So it is not in the king's interest to let them remain. If it is pleasing to the king, let it be decreed that they be destroyed, and I will pay 10,000 talents of silver into the hands of those who carry on the king's business, to put it into the king's treasuries. So the king took his signet ring and put his hand and gave it to Haman, the enemy of the Jews. So, Father, we thank you that this whole story is a divine reversal. What the enemy meant for evil, you turned for good. And, Father, we just thank you that even now you are causing a divine reversal in our nation, God. We thank you, Lord, that the church is rising up and being a voice in this hour, being a loud voice in this hour. God, you're raising up Esthers and Mordecais to stand for righteousness, to stand for our children, God, to stand for our nation, to turn back to the original intent of this nation, which is one nation under God. Father, we thank you for what you're doing in Jesus' name. God.
You're doing a new thing. You're doing
your spirit, Lord. Pour it out, pour it out. Pour out your spirit, God. Pour it out, pour it out. Pour out your spirit, God.
Raise up your people, God. Raise up your church to be mighty and strong, to be powerful in the earth, Lord. Lord, make us righteous, the righteous are as bold as lions, God, that we would not draw back in this hour. But God, who knows if we've been raised up for such a time as this. Proverbs 16:33, man may throw the dice, but the Lord determines how they fall. Man can has his plans, but God is greater. God is more powerful. He's greater than every plan of the enemy. So we thank you, Lord, for intervening for Esther and her people, and intervening in, even in our own lives, Lord. We thank you for that. In Jesus' name.
Spirit, you give is power, love, and a sound mind. So take all fear and wash it all away. Spirit, you give is power, love, and a sound mind. So take all fear and wash it all away.
Perfect love casts out fear.
You give is power, love, and a sound mind. So take all fear and wash it all away. The spirit you give is power, love, and a sound mind. So take all fear and wash it all away.
Goes to Esther and says, what are you going to do about this, basically? And he says, just because you're in the king's palace doesn't mean that you are going to be protected. So in Esther 4:14, for if you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance will rise for the Jews from another place, and you and your father's house will perish. And who knows whether you have attained royalty for such a time as this. So Esther called a fast. She said, go assemble all the Jews and fast for me. Do not eat or drink for 3 days, day or night. I and my maidens also will fast in the same way. And thus I will go into the king, which is not according to the law. And if I perish, I perish. So, Lord, we thank you for the Esthers and Mordecais in our nation who are standing for righteousness, who are standing for the truth, and who will not back down even in this hour, who are going to fill the bus to go down to Austin to be a voice for our children, to stand for our children and push back against what they're doing with our children, God. Father, we ask for the whole, all Storehouse would want to go down there. I pray that the bus will be filled to capacity, and it will be a glorious trip, and it'll bring, and we will have boldness to stand for you, Lord, to stand for our rights as citizens, for our rights to protect our children against things that are being taught that are not of you, God. So, Father, raise up your people even now to be bold and be strong in this hour, in Jesus' name. Thank you.
thank you for righteous judgments. Balance the scales in the land, Lord. Thank you for your righteous judgments, God. Balance the scales in the land, Lord. Thank you for your righteous judgments.
Truth of
Story goes, Esther and all the Jewish people fasted for 3 days, and then Esther went before the king, and the king held out his scepter and said, Esther, I would give you half of the kingdom. What is your request? So Esther requested the king and Haman would come to a banquet of wine. So that's what happened. She had a banquet of wine. And then after that, she said, I'd like you to come again tomorrow night and have another banquet of wine. And in the fullness of time, as she waited for the Lord, Haman disclosed his irate hate for the Jews. And the tables were turned. In Esther 7, it says, now the king and Haman came to drink wine with Esther the queen. And the king said to Esther on the second day, also as they drank their wine at the banquet, what is your petition, Queen Esther? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Even if half of the kingdom, it shall be done. Then Queen Esther answered and said, if I have found favor in your sight, O king, and if it please the king, let my life be given as my petition and my people as my request. For we have been sold, I and my people, to be destroyed, to be killed and annihilated. And so the king says, who is this person that has caused this? Who would presume to do this? And Esther said, a foe and an enemy is this wicked Haman. Then Haman became terrified before the king and queen. And Haman was hung on his own gallows. So, Father, we just thank you that there is going to be a divine reversal, even in our nation, as in the book of Esther. Things are going to turn around by divine intervention. Father, when your people rise up, when they become a voice, when they will not back down, Father, I thank you that you will hear from heaven and you will bring justice to the earth in Jesus' name.
Derision.
You laugh at the you turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, you turn it for good. You turn it for good.
Esther 8:11. The king granted the Jews who were in each and every city the right to assemble and defend their lives, to destroy, to kill, and to annihilate the entire army of any people or province who might attack them. A copy of the edict was issued as law in each and every province, was published to all the people, so that the Jews should be ready for this day to avenge themselves on their enemies. So, Father, we thank you. What the enemy meant for evil, you have turned to good. Instead of mourning and weeping, the Jewish people were dancing and shouting for joy. Father, we thank you for this Feast of Purim, where have you set the captives free, where you turned things around. When it looked like you weren't going to move, God, you moved and changed things in an instant. So, Lord, we give you all the glory for what you're doing in our nation, God. We declare there is a rebirth even in our nation, God. A turning, a massive turning of hearts towards you, God. We thank you for the revival that's coming. We thank you for many, the harvest of souls that's coming into the kingdom. Father, we thank you for this next election cycle, that you will be glorified. You will be magnified in our elections in the name of Jesus. That righteousness will reign in our elections. In Jesus' name, we thank you.
Give you my word.
Father, we thank you, just as you prepared Esther for a year until the time was right. In the fullness of time, you raised up Esther to change a nation. And Father, I thank you that even now, you're raising up the bride of Christ to have that oil of intimacy. Like Matthew 25, the virgins with the oil. Father, I thank you that you're raising up your church even now to have that oil of intimacy, to run with you, to not draw back, to be bold as lions, God, to love their lives, not even unto death. Father, we thank you for this bride that you're raising up and that we're a part of it. We say yes and amen to all that you have for us, God. As the bride of Christ, God, use us for your glory in this hour, in Jesus' name.
We really need your oil. We really want your spirit, God. So pour it out, pour it out, God. We really need your oil. We really need your oil, Lord. We really want your spirit, God. So pour it out.
Thank you.
as clean vessels.
In the authority that you've given us, Lord. It's time to speak up. It's time to rise up and be all that you've called us to be. Lord, raise up your bride. Make her spotless and pure in this hour, in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Shall come to pass that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. And also on my men servants and my maid servants, I will pour out my spirit in those days. So, Father, we're asked for your outpouring of your spirit upon our nation, upon the nations and the earth, God, an outpouring like we've never seen before, God. We cry out to you, God. We are hungry and thirsty for more of you, God. And we ask, won't you come, God? Won't you pour out your spirit in this hour, God? We have to have more. We can't do it without you, God. So will you come and pour out your spirit upon us in Jesus' name? praying out of Isaiah 40. I just kept hearing it yesterday, and I'm hearing it today. The strength of youth is failing. Even youth grow tired and weary. Vigorous young men stumble and fall. But those who wait upon the Lord gain new strength. I just feel the Lord saying, aren't you tired of problem solving? Wait on me. Instead of problem solving, prepare the way. Isaiah 40:3, it says, clear the way for the Lord in the wilderness. Make smooth in the desert a highway for our God. Let every valley be lifted up and every mountain and hill be made low. And let the rough ground become a plain and the rugged terrain a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord will be revealed and all flesh will see it together. A voice says, what shall I call out? All flesh is grass, and all its loveliness is like the flower of the field. The grass withers and the flower fades when the breath of the Lord blows on it. Surely the people are grass, and the grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our Lord stands forever. God, we're asking to prepare the way for your glory. That the glory of the Lord would be revealed in our midst. God, we are tired of problem solving in our flesh. God, we're asking that you would come. We're waiting on you. We're asking for renewed strength, renewed vision. You said that those who wait on you will mount up on wings like eagles. God, that we could ask different questions and we could see different answers. That we could prepare the way for your glory to be revealed in our midst, in this day and in our time. That we would mount up and see from a new perspective. God, we're asking for renewed strength right now. For the body of Christ, for our leadership team here at Storehouse. For all of us here that are laboring to see your glory come, God, we're asking for renewed strength. We wait on you. We change our mind from problem solving to preparing the way, to moving out every obstacle to your presence, God. We change our mind today in Jesus' name.
Strength. just want to tag on to that. Isaiah 40 says, prepare for God's arrival. Make the road straight and smooth, a highway fit for our God. Fill in the valleys, level off the hills, smooth out the ruts and clear out the rocks. Then God's bright glory will shine and everyone will see it. Yes, just as God has said. So, Father, I just thank you for those areas in our lives that are being smoothed out. Father, I thank you for those mindsets that are being made straight. Lord, I just thank you for those heart issues that are being resolved. Lord, I just thank you that we lean on you, Jesus, that you're our strength, that we move into new places because of you, Jesus. Just like in Song of Solomon, leaning on you, that we'd come up leaning on you for the world to see. So, Father, I just thank you for what you're doing, what you've already started. And I thank you for your glory that will be seen in Jesus' name.
Prepare a way. Prepare a way in me for your glory to fall down. Your glory to fall down, Lord. Prepare a way. Prepare a way in me for your glory to fall down. Glory to fall down. Prepare a way. Prepare. Flatten the high ground.
Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, my enemies and foes, they stumbled and fell. Though an army may encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war may rise against me, in this I will be confident. The one thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and inquire in his temple. Father, we ask, God, that we would dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of our life, that the one thing that we desire is you, Lord, to be in your temple, to inquire into your word, Lord. We ask, God, for more. We ask for a strengthening of hearts today, a strengthening of our minds today, for that one thing that our eyes are set on eternity, not in the here and now, but God. Our momentary light afflictions are nothing compared to the eternal weight of your glory, God. So, Lord, help us to be a people of one thing, a people that keeps our eyes on eternity and the things to come. Father, we thank you for it in Jesus' name.
Shadow of your wings. And God, I thank you for pouring out your strength in us would meet us right where we are, God. We set our gaze on you. We look at you as the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. The knowledge of who you are, God. Let that flood every cell of our membrane, of our body, of our DNA, God. God, every bone, every sinew. I just prophesy now. Come alive. Come alive. Come alive in your physical bodies. Come alive in your minds. Come alive in your spirit, man. Rise up, rise up, O army. Let the prophetic hit you. Sharia Korea Batiti Alabokondaraba Shandaraba Shandarabati Nanaya Boku. Let the words of life nourish you in your inner man. Hinini Ayadulia Bakandaraba Shota Dadalia Bakoti Abashi. God, I'm asking, come as a father. Shalabakandarada, we draw near to you just as in Goshen. We draw near to you, God. I rebuke every arrow against your people now. Let your wings cover us. Cover us. Cover us, God. Come, God. Come, God. Let the weary cry out. Let the weary cry out, God. I thank you that you hear us. You hear our cry. Sholaba kandalabashi tiatotolaba kandalabashi. Shoreba kandarade abati tiatati alaba kandarade abati. We ask you for milk. We ask you, God, refresh us now. Handalaba halaba kuliaba shandalaba kalabashi. Halaba kandalaba shalarabole abakandalabashi. Nourish us as the many-breasted one, God. Heli andarada bakaria bashondala bakandala bashi. Feed us. Feed us. We draw near to you, God. Your heartbeat, God, I thank you. Flow, 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 flow. On earth as it is in heaven, let it flow, God, the rivers. Life. Shut up in our bones, God. Nourish your leaders today, God. Be refreshed by the power of God's love. Let your blood run down, God, over us. I had a dream last night where I was milking a cow, and this milk was very important. It was like getting gold, and I feel like the Holy Spirit is saying, go back to the milk of the Word. Return back to the first place. Turn to the gospel. The simplicity of the gospel, the simplicity of Jesus on the cross. established in this place of the sacrifice of the Lamb. God, we love you. The beauty of communion, to be nourished by the washing of your word, God. We love you. We bless you.
Just picturing Jesus as the one who holds the seven stars in his hand. These are the leaders of seven churches, the angels of the seven churches. But also, I just feel the Lord saying, see me as the crown of creation, the one who rules over creation, the one who rules over the created order. God, I ask for the mysteries of how you rule creation. I ask for the mysteries of how you find your leaders in creation, of how you refresh them, just as you did with Job as he questioned you about the created order and about his life in the created order and what you said to him. You said, I hold the stars in my hand. I know the answers. I know the mysteries. God, I'm asking for mysteries revealed about who you are in this season, about who you are as the crown of creation and how you sit over the circle of the earth and how you govern everything in it. God, we need to know. We need to know that we're not at the center of creation. You are. God, I'm asking for the spirit of the fear of the Lord. As we see you as one who holds the stars, as the one who rules creation, God, we fear you. You're the one who rules and who understands us, who feeds us, who satisfies the longing of every living thing. God, we're asking to know you in this way, in Jesus' name. For the body of Christ, the bride, to ask the right questions. I just declare a turning point right now, a perspective over the bride. just like Job had, chapter 33, just a turning point to begin to ask the right questions, to stop the accusations over God, and to begin to ask the right questions, to begin to see you rightly, Jesus. God, I just ask right now for a turning point in perspective. We begin to ask the right things and to see you rightly. The mysteries would begin to be revealed to us, God. We're asking to connect the dots towards your return. God, we need to know. We need to know you for real. God, we're asking for the right perspective right now in Jesus' name. A turning point right now. A humility over the body of Christ right now. To throw off self-righteousness, to throw it off. Humbling ourselves in the fear of the Lord. Understanding who you are in the created order. That you hold, Pallades, the seven stars, you hold them in your hands. You understand what's going on in our hearts, God. That we are like grass, that we will wither away, God, without your breath. We're asking to understand you, Jesus. Jesus.